us about your life. How are Alex's children? Tell us about them.
I want to say that the children are very brave. The first year and the second year even were very difficult for Alina. She argued with teachers and with other people. But now she's very wise. She has set a goal for herself to get an education. So she's studying.
Tell us about them.
She's exactly like Oleg. There were many questions about Oleg, and then her teacher said, Alina, it's difficult for you here. You just need to change schools. And then she said, Grandma, I listened at first, and I wanted to run away from there. And then the teacher told her to change schools. So she turned around and said, I studied here before, I'm studying here now, and I'm going to continue to study at this school. If you don't like it, you leave. She was in the fifth grade. Then she turned around and walked away.
How close was he with his children? How did he raise them?
He loved them very much. He took them everywhere, to the mountains, to the beach. He was always with them. If he calls or writes, Alina and him still discuss which books to read. To this day, she still listens to him very much. It was very difficult for Vlad. He didn't call him dad, he called him Oleg. Oleg was everything to him, and then suddenly he was gone. Vlad had very big eyes. He looks at you with these big eyes and asks, where is Oleg? Where did he go? Is it my fault that he left?
How often do you write to Oleg?
We try to write to Oleg often. Of course, we rarely receive letters from him. Maybe once every 1.5 months or once a month. But we write him. I write maybe 4 letters a month. I just write about the children, what they're doing, where they've been, how their studies are going. I don't write about anything else. Of course, we don't write about our problems. Everything is always going well for us. The children are good. All is well.
How does he sound? What was his voice like?
I cried so much when he was transferred there. I did not know that he was in the detention facility, or whatever it's called. There was just nothing, no letters, no phone calls. I didn't know where he was or what he was doing. And then he called. I cried nonstop for a week, maybe, because his voice was like that of a person who has been destroyed. It was terrible. Then a letter arrived, and he wrote that everything was fine. During the next phone call, he was happy. He had received a photo of the children. Of course, he hadn't seen them for a long time. He had been sent photos before, but there was a 1.5 years difference, and in that time, they had grown up. He was very happy with these photos. His voice was chipper, and that meant he wasn't sick, and everything was more or less fine there. But at first, it was very scary.
What does he say about conditions he is held in?
He never says anything. He says, I'm fine. I say, Oleg, do you need anything? I have everything I need, Mom, he says.
He doesn't want to meet.
No, he doesn't. He says it won't bring anyone joy. Not us, not him. It will only make things harder. We wanted to come to Rostov. I said, I'll come with the children. Rostov wasn't that far away, but he said, don't. I've seen people who have been visited by their children and what happens to them later. For me, Ural is very far away. I have no idea how to get there. Alina and I looked at the map, but that's just a map. I can only imagine how long it took him to get there and in what condition he got there. My eyesight is poor now, and it's difficult for me to get there myself. I really want to see him. It's frightening to think that it's possible I may never see him again.
Do you speak with Sasha Kolchenko's mother?
I don't talk with anyone.
Is it hard?
It's hard, especially because he's so young. I tear up when I think about it. If I see his mother, I might faint. It's very difficult for me. I will never reproach Oleg about what happened. This is his life. He was already 40 years old. It was his choice. Kolchenko is younger. I feel more sorry for him, because he's a young boy.
What would you want to say to Oleg?
We love you very much, son, and we're waiting for you. I want him to get out and be with the children again. Vlad needs a father. He's a sick boy. He needs development. He's not stupid. He reads wonderfully. I'm afraid that this is how the years will pass. People will forget about him, and he will be in prison for 20 years.